It sounds fun.
Is any time going on?
Yeah, all the time, isn't it?
All the time.
Hello, I'm Brad from Tommy's Yard.
I'm Tony from Tommy's Yard.
Sorry about the noise above. We're in our warehouse at the moment, and it's only a single skin roof up there.
It's hammering down.
Absolutely hammering down. And we sprung a leak, which Sam was going to try and hide from you. But I believe honesty is the best policy.
So
if you want to show him the leak, Sam.
We've only just moved into here, actually. It's a work in progress still, actually, to be honest with you. We just renovated the flat. There's a flat above here.
We've renovated it, and now we're just going to start on the shop itself.
That's how we didn't realise about it. We haven't been here before. When it's raining.
We've never been here, have we?
No.
We better get out there tomorrow and fix
that. So
we're
going to do that. So, today, house two, we're going to talk about compression fittings.
It's quite rude, isn't it, at top?
You're just
a cup of tea.
Yeah, but that's gentleman-like.
Yeah, but I'm doing my little finger. My pinky.
Right, compression fittings. We're going to speak about these and how to do it out properly.
By the way, he's a football star, you see. Yeah. He likes to play football. And you see
he's got a kick in,
yeah,
he's
got a kick in, yeah.
Right, we're going to talk about how to do these up properly, how you should do them, what are the olives for inside, and we had to hand a couple of isolators.
15mm?
22mm. Older plumbers call them baller fixes. Different
you want to show them, Sandy?
There we go.
See,
22.
Mine's bigger.
And mine's smaller.
That's just life, isn't it?
So, right, what have we got?
So we got, when you undo the nut itself, inside there, you'll have
a brass olive.
Brass olive. Now I'm getting married in a couple of weeks' time. Sam wants me to show you again. That would work perfect
for a ring.
As a wedding ring.
There's a 15mm one.
That'll fit your little fingers.
Don't think so. 15mm one and a 22mm one.
Now, that's a good wedding ring.
It is a good wedding
that
ring.
That is. If that was stronger metal, because that'd bend, wouldn't it?
Yeah, soft metal brass, or that thin anyway. There's loads of obviously different sizes you can get. These are your most common sizes in your property, 15 and 22.
Sam, you've got a screwdriver, a flathead screwdriver or something?
Yeah, we'll show you how to do that. So what we're going to do is show you how to put these together. Right, so here's my 15mm bit of copper, and here's my nut and the olive. So what you want to be doing is stick your nut onto your pipe, your olive onto your pipe. Like so, and then when you're putting your bit of copper into your fitting,
it's loud.
It is loud, isn't it? You'll push it in until it stops. You'll feel it stop, you'll hear it stop. Now, that's your point then, when you push your nut onto your thread. Do it up hand tight, like that. Now, at this point, your pipe will still pull in and out of your fitting.
So on that note then, you know you've undone that to put that on?
Yeah.
Why couldn't you just leave that done up?
Sometimes you get olives which are a little bit tighter. And if you get 15mm pipe, it all depends where you get it from as well, deviates in size by a couple of mil. Yeah. So sometimes you won't be able to push it into that fitting. That's why I just said do it that way, because it's easier.
That's a 22mm, but I was looking at the gauge thickness of it.
But sometimes the pipe deviates a little bit. Your olive could be a little bit off, and your pipe a little bit off.
That's a bit tighter to get on.
Yeah, and you won't get on. So that's the reason you do that.
That's a little bit tighter, isn't it?
Yeah.
So just undo that. Put that on first.
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
That
going to go on there? Yeah, do you know what I've got? There you go. I've got a bit of dirty pipe. Yeah.
That's it. So that's
how that sits in there.
And that sits on there like
that's
that.
That's it, mate. Push it on. You've got a bit of king pipe there, haven't you?
A bit kinky, isn't it?
See
it?
And that's another thing you
want to
be careful of. When you cut your pipe,
make sure it's a nice, clean, straight cut. Clean cut. Because we ain't got no 22mm cutters in the van. It's raining.
Yeah.
And I'm getting the air wet.
Otherwise, you could cause yourself leaks as well. So yeah, you put your nut and olive on.
Yep.
Do it up hand tight.
I'm at that stage.
You're at that stage. Now, what you've got here, we've got a pair of adjustables and we've got a little pair of pump pliers here.
Yeah.
You can use whatever you've got. I'll use the adjustables for the nut, and then you hold your fitting with your pump pliers.
So hold that down.
Hold like that there. Like that there, and then you tighten up. You'll adjust your adjustables so they fit whatever size you've got, and then you tighten up. Righty tighty, lefty loosey.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Righty tighty,
righty tighty, lefty loosey.
Where'd you learn that at school?
That's another story, actually.
You didn't go to school.
Nah. So that's it.
How tight do you want to go with that?
You want to tighten that fitting up. You want to give it some. You don't want to leave it loose. You want to go round on it until you can really feel it pushing back on you.
Because some of these fittings, I've seen you do them as well. We've used these are good fittings.
Yeah.
Well, we sell them on Tommy's Yard, and we've tested everything we sell, so we know it's good. But some fittings we've actually bought from the shops before,
and they're no good.
And are no good. And what they do, they let bite.
Yeah.
Where is the, do you think it's the olives?
It's
say?
The olives. Yeah, it's the olives. In, the olives are rubbish in them. What you'll also find with these, I mean, the way we're putting these together is for any compression fitting.
Yeah.
But we just add these baller fixes, I call them baller fixes, but they're isolated valves, to hand. What you also get on ones which ain't as good as well, the nut leaks. When you undo the nut, it leaks. So, yeah.
So, do you want to talk about that isolating bit?
Yeah. So, what an isolator does, it does exactly what it says in the name, really. It isolates water.
Sam, can you see? I've got the big pipe here. Yeah. Can you see that? Can you see down there? Down lower? Where am I? Oh, there we go, Sam. You
got
see,
it?
Yeah, just about. Inside there, you'll see that metal ball. And you see that's shut off. So if you was to connect the pipe into there now, if you turn that closed, it'll stop the water flowing through. But then what you do, if you open it, quarter turn.
Half turn,
you can see it's open now. So you can see right through. So that obviously lets the water by.
Yeah, and that'll let your water by. You can get a couple of these isolators. We're just talking about these because we've got to hand.
Yeah, but it's a good fitting to talk about because you use these quite often. Yeah, not a lot of plumbers do, and they're good fittings.
Yeah. Isolators you want to be using on everything, anything which...
Surface mount.
And anything which has got a water source to it. A tap, a basin, a shower. You want to be putting isolators on it. For the simple reason is any problems later on down the line, you haven't either got to turn your mains off or you haven't got to drain one of your tanks down. You just turn it.
So like for example, if you had a dodgy
toilet.
Tap, a dodgy toilet, a leaking toilet or a leaking kitchen tap.
If your toilet was fed from your cold water storage tank in your loft and you haven't got an isolator on, you've now got to drain down your cold water storage tank in your loft.
And that's a lot of wasted water.
It's a lot of wasted water and it's more time for a plumber to be coming round if you're charging by the hour to be there.
You bought
cars,
didn't you?
Yeah, a lot of money, yeah.
A lot of money. Is that
why
you've got a big car?
Yeah.
That's why he drives a Mercedes.
Yeah,
no, he drives a work van. He's an honest plumber.
So, with isolators as well, while we're on the subject of these, with an isolator, you'll always find you've got an arrow on them. So your arrow indicates the way your water wants to flow through your isolator. These isolators in particular, you can get different kinds of isolators. These ones aren't full bore isolators. If you can you see that, Sam? You made it out. You can see in the middle, the radius of the pipe, or the isolator, shuts down a little bit. With a full bore isolator, that won't. And that ball, what you see in the middle, will be a full size, and that will spin round. So you're getting full pressure through it then. These ones aren't like that. They're the full bore pressure ones, if you're using, or your house has got, a gravity system.
Right.
So you don't want to be shutting down your pressure anymore because it's gravity fed, so the pressure's not that great anyway.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But for main pressures, these are absolutely fine. It's not going to shut it down that much.
And we're cheap on them.
Very cheap on them, actually.
We're cheap, didn't we?
Yeah.
How do we sell them, Sam?
25s?
Packs of 25 or 20s, is it?
10s.
Is it 10s, Evie? Might be right.
Sam,
go and get one, mate.
Grab a pack of them, Sam. So that's your isolators.
We'll put a link below as well on that, just to touch that. We'll put a link below where you can buy these from on Tommy's Yard. We've got a special offer at the moment on trade deals.
Yeah.
They come in packed, clear packs like that.
What's that, pack of?
10.
Yeah, there's a pack of 10, 22s. There we go. These are West Coast ones, so these are really the best ones you can get, to be honest with you. We've had no problems with them. Personal preference, but these ones are really good. I use these daily.
Yeah,
And we never have no problems with them. Compression fittings. That's
he does get leaked when he forgets to tighten them up.
Yeah, now and again. Yeah, look, everyone gets leaked. Any plumber what tells
or
you don't
the
get
apprentice.
A leak. Yeah, it's always your apprentice.
It's always my fault.
Any plumber who tells you don't get a leak is a liar.
No, of course
it is a liar. It's just numbers. It's just mathematical.
Mathematical, isn't it? If you're fitting 1,000 fittings a year,
you're gonna get a leak.
Of course you are.
You're gonna get a leak.
Yeah.
But yeah, so that's compression.
Don't get problems like that.
That's compression. This here. If you just disregard that middle bit, that could be any compression fitting. That could be an elbow, that could be a T, that could be anything. They all work on the same principle.
Why? Because the T's got 3 spouts.
Yeah, it's got a spout there.
Yeah, but you should disregard that bit.
Oh, yeah.
So
it
could be a T.
Well, it could be.
It could be an elbow.
It could be a coupling, and it could be a T if you had another bit out of the middle for clever bollocks. But yeah, that's a compression fitting. We can talk about other compression fittings actually.
another time.
We'll do another time. We'll do another video and we'll get the whole selection out.
Yeah.
Running a bit behind time, aren't we?
Yeah.
Sam said to us, we've got to get a video up on YouTube because they're hating.
What we can do next time is talk about maybe quarter tone stuff. No, the quarter tone stuff we was looking at the other day, because that's real good to, use, good to use, especially if you're fitting them yourself.
Yeah.
Quarter tone stuff.
They're more expensive, aren't they?
They're a little bit more expensive.
Looks well when it's done.
They
it looks well.
They look really good. So yeah, that's it really. That's your compression fittings.
Post it soon. See you later.
Ta-da.
Cheers.